Let's quickly talk about route params and how you use them. So if I do a colon here and type something like message, I can inject something here called route params into my controller. And now I can simply say that our message is route params.message. So that's going to, parse this out of the URL, pass along as a parameter in the route, and then I can just look it up by that key of message. So if I refresh now, it's going to give me nothing because there is no message here. But if I say something like hello, it'll render out hello. If I say something like bonjour, it'll render that out simply because I'm grabbing a message off of the route params object. Now, this isn't a typical scenario. What you'd usually have is something like, we'll say this is our map. And then you'd have like a country slash state slash city. And then you can simply have like a map page. Let's build out our new message. We'll have it be address. And we'll just say our address is route params country plus comma. Do it this way. Country, state, and city. And then all we have to do is see if we refresh here. We got nothing because we need to build out our URL. Like this is our map and the USA. My state is Utah and I live in Orem. Please don't come and stalk me. So it has address of USA, Utah, Orem. Because it took these out of the URL and just simply provided them as route parameters. And I can look them up this way. So that's route parameters. We'll see different ways of looking into them as we get into things like redirect to.